Hello there, Fred. Good morning. You're watching Proactive London, and the new CEO, Callum Sommerton, is joining us now from Chill Brands Group. Well, you've been in the job, what, just over a month?
Good morning, Katie. Yeah, it's great to speak with you this morning. I have, very exciting times. And as you'll see now, I'm out in our Colorado office and joining the team here.
And what have you been up to so far? Has it been a busy, busy month then, I would imagine? How's it going?
Yeah, very much so. So we've recently closed out our fundraising and sought shareholder approval, which we've received. We've also announced an open offer to allow our existing or long-term shareholders to participate on equivalent terms so that they can also average down at this price. And we've announced a variety of other exciting business updates relating to our retail, digital, and just generally our operations.
Yeah, you certainly have. I've been reading through them actually before we came on the call. So you've told investors that you're working to concentrate on building closer ties with retail partners.
Yeah, so I mean, taking it back a step to January, I understand a lot of our investors might have been surprised or shocked when we announced that we were stepping away from our original retail rollout timelines. I think the reality was that we were racing to hit goals that weren't necessarily coming with a financial prize. And that financial prize is, of course, sell through. We weren't equipped eternally, and we certainly weren't equipped financially to roll out to thousands of stores at the time. So by creating these stronger links with retail partners, by getting to know them, by getting into the stores and having a very active presence in them, sure, it's slower growth, but it's more sustainable growth that will ultimately allow us to succeed in the retail channel long term.
Mm-hmm. And you're referring to your new kind of preference for a direct distribution model, which replaces a prior master distribution deal as well that you had, right?
Absolutely right. So in the past, all sales in the retail channel were first made to Ox Distributing. They were then passed on through another sale to distributors and retailers before they actually landed in the convenience store environment. Now we're simplifying that. We'll be going direct to the endpoint, selling to the retailers, in some cases, some distributors. But really what we're trying to do here is generate that close relationship that allow us to build up sales data, allow us to build up a rapport with our partners, and actually just make those stores as successful as they can possibly be.
Mm-hmm. And I understand this new approach is to be combined with a wider digital strategy as well, and a wholesale order portal.
Yes, yeah, absolutely. So digital is a huge thing for us. We're trying in our tobacco alternative space to take what's typically been a very analog industry and to move it into the 21st century through digital sales. That is a task that will take some doing, but for retailers, we're trying to achieve that by creating a very smooth journey to ordering Chill products. Rather than placing an order with a warehouse somewhere and a distributor, they can log on to chill.com, place their order, or even join our subscription service and get the products direct to their own warehouse or direct to their own back doors, ready to sell in a matter of days. So that's the first element of our digital strategy. The second really plays down to the consumer themselves. We've bought chill.com. It's a fantastic asset, but certainly it's one that came with a hefty price tag. And we're working very hard now to make sure that every moment and every sale on that portal counts. And so that comes into SEO, digital marketing, and a number of other campaigns that we're about to kick off that hopefully should drive more traffic and generate more sales.
Mm-hmm. And you've spoken about how it's time for you to capitalize on these advantages that you have. Maybe just conclude with what the advantages are and how you're going to be capitalizing on them.
Yeah, absolutely. I think in terms of Chill as a brand, we have an advantage because we're sat right in the middle of the market. You've got people at one end trying to cater to perhaps cannabis consumers. At the other end, you have the luxury side of the market. And some people there are catering I would say, a more hipster community with the flavors, the color profiles, the way that they brand their products. Chill is an accessible product. It's an accessible brand that anybody can understand. And I think that the beauty really of it is that you say Chill and you know what you're getting. It does what it says on the tin. So that's the first advantage. And we really will capitalize on that by getting the name out there more, getting brand awareness with consumers in all of our relevant demographics. Aside from that, we also have a very differentiated set of products. So while there are a lot of wellness CBD companies in the world and operating today, we have tobacco alternative products. We have our chew pouches, we have our smokes, alongside the cosmetics, tinctures and gummies that everybody knows. And so what we're trying to do is create a product that does stand out on the shelf, something that's a little bit different to the wellness products that people might be used to with CBD. And really by doing that, we think that we'll be able to capture an area of the market that currently is underserved.
All right, Callum, well, great to meet you. I'm sure we'll be chatting a lot as we follow your journey there. Just a month in the role there as CEO at Chill Brands Group here on Proactive.
Thanks, Katie. Appreciate it.